Oh my God, that is so good. I'm so happy.
Standing underneath the lights, look into each other's eyes. Tired snowflakes are coming down, collapse into water when they hit the ground. I hear the sound of empty streets.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Mari. Thank you so much for stopping by, and today I'm gonna show you guys how I make a healthy, kid-friendly broccoli mac and cheese. I actually show you guys a bit on my vlog maybe 2 weeks ago, I'm not sure. Now I'm gonna show you guys every step of the way, the ingredients, how much of what I put and everything. It's really yummy. Harry has been a really fussy eater, but he did eat some tiny bits last time. So let's get to it.
These are pretty much all the ingredients they use. I got some butter in here, some whole milk, got some mozzarella cheese. You can use other types of cheese as well, but I prefer to use mozzarella because it's a bit healthier than cheddar cheese. We got some macaroni. You can use, of course, different pastas. Last time that I did, I think I used a fusilli, a three-color fusilli. And of course, we got some broccoli.
First thing that I'm gonna do is to cook the pasta and boil the broccoli a bit for about 5 to 10 minutes. It all depends on how you like, because I like to smash the broccoli a lot so Harry doesn't see much of the broccoli when he eats. Like I said, he's been a really fussy eater. Those of you who don't know me, Harry is my son. He just turned one. He used to eat pretty well, but it's been such a nightmare to get him to eat anything after he turned one. I've been trying to come up with all the different types of recipes. Before I forget, when I put the pasta to boil with the water, I don't put a lot of water as I normally would if I was just cooking like a regular pasta, because the secret for a good mac and cheese is to boil the pasta with milk, whole milk. But I don't like to use only milk, so I kind of mix water and milk to actually cook the pasta. So pretty much just like half the water, then after the water boil, I put the pasta and then I mix with the milk to like cover all the pasta. I'm gonna show you guys.
Okay, so now that the water is boiling, I'm gonna put all the pasta here, mix it up, and top up with a bit of milk. Just a tiny bit more. As you can see, the broccoli is almost done.
Now we should just wait till the pasta is ready so we can mix a bit of the butter and the cheese and everything.
So you can see in here that the pasta is clearly ready. Just mix it up a bit and then I'll get some butter.
Oh, you can see the broccoli is definitely ready. I just need to slice it up a bit before mixing with the pasta.
With the butter, I don't have a correct measure, so I'll just slice some bits, add it in the pasta. Oh, and in here I put on one or two, like the lowest possible, make sure that it doesn't stick. If you think it's like too dry or something like that, you can add more milk and add more butter. Just say it by eye as you go. Add it as long as you think it's needed. If you like more creamy or less creamy, I don't know, I prefer more creamy, so I will add a bit more of the butter. And while this is melting, I'll go get some cheese. One of the most important parts, you guys.
Like I've said before, I use mozzarella because I think it's a bit healthier than cheddar cheese, but you can use whatever cheese you want. The quantity, it's like the butter and the milk, and like flavor ice. At least one whole packet of 250 grams. But I got another one in here because I think I'm gonna put some more because I like it pretty creamy.
So as I was adding the cheese, I thought it was recording, but it's not. My fault. I already put like half of the package. And as I was saying and didn't record anything, I like to put half of the package and then mix it up a bit before putting the rest. As you can see, it's starting to get really creamy. Mm-hmm. Now I'm just gonna turn it off a bit, put it aside so I can prepare the broccoli. And I kind of go doing like this. As you can see, it's pretty much done. Now I'm just gonna add the broccoli to the pan with the pasta.
Now I'll just mix the pasta like it is. And because I like really creamy, like I told you guys, and add a bit more milk, a bit more butter before adding the rest of the cheese.
I'm just gonna mix it up a bit.
In here, it's on the minimum heat.
See, it's the whole package so far.
I'm gonna add a bit more of milk, and like I said, you just play it by eyes. You go add it milk or butter, or even if you want more cheese, as you wish. It all depends on how creamy you like. Oh my god, it's so cheesy that I don't even think I need to add more cheese, to be honest.
Look how cheesy. Oh my god, that looks so good.
Oh, and I forgot to say, you can add a bit of salt if you want. And that's done, guys. That's pretty much it. I'm gonna taste it just for a quick bite. Let's see. Oh my god, it's so cheesy. Ah, look. Mm. Oh my god, you guys, I need to get some more. Oh my god, that is so good. I'm so happy. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you tried this recipe. I'd love to hear what you think. Also, guys, don't forget to thumbs up, to subscribe for more videos. I do daily vlogs and extra videos every week. Also, click the bell so you get a notification every time I post a new video. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye, guys.